Weird.
So yeah, I don't know what's up.
I got a 8.
Okay, so you got a 8. All right. I'm going to need you to take an acrobatics check, actually. Because
Okay.
you're like standing still, you're not trying to climb.
That's plus 0. Oh, okay. It's D20 then. I got a 9.
9 total. Okay. All right, you're going to. Shit, is that correct? Blah, 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 blah. Okay, yeah, you're gonna go ahead and fall.
Okay.
So you're gonna take. You can roll another acrobatics to try and break your fall. If you'd like to.
I got a 6.
Okay, so you're gonna take 1d6 damage and fall damage as you, like, whiplash on your rope. Okay?
My rope, okay.
Okay, so you're gonna take 3 damage. Okay, so you go ahead and. Castor goes, "Are you okay down there?
I go, yeah,
You
I'm
need?"
fine. Just now.
He goes, he says, "All right, he says, just wait there. I'll see what I can do. Just climb up to where you were at."
All right, so I'm gonna do that.
Okay.
Just the spot I was at before.
So he
Does it take
climbs
a
up all
turn?
the way to the top, to the basically like a little to the hollow opening, and he climbs into it, and he kind of like ducks down real quick. And he goes, "There's things up here."
I
He
go.
goes, hurry up, get up here." And he like tosses his rope, like he repositions his grappling hook and tugs it to make sure it's secure, and then tosses it down to you, like the rope.
Okay. I'm gonna try to climb normal speed then,
Okay.
to get to him faster.
All right, so make some checks. You're trying to beat a DC 5. So more. 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 Okay, one more. Okay, you're good. Or wait. No, that was a one. Fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Roll to catch yourself, 23.
That's a 20. If only though.
Oh, it is. Yeah, so it's a 33 then. For a crit thing.
Crit fail.
Catch yourself while falling.
Fall.
Practicing
And then crit.
positive of a test.
Success.
Attack.
Catch myself.
Okay. So you're going to. Okay. How far do you fall when you catch yourself? All right. I'm gonna say that you take 1d6 damage to catch yourself because you don't have a Piton on these ones. So you've been climbing this whole time, and then you fall without the Piton in place. So you're going to take 1d6 damage when you like catch yourself. Does that make sense?
Okay.
Because it doesn't say like how far you're supposed to fall when you catch yourself. Okay. So. All right. So you're going to take 2 more damage. Roll. 2 more times, successfully. Hopefully. It's like anything but a one, essentially. Okay. All right, so you scramble your way back up there, and he goes, "Are you okay? You gonna be all right?"
I'm like, yeah, I just show him my like
Okay. I'm going.
scrapes on my
He
hands
like
and shake
immediately
him.
like pulls you down. So he's like trying. He's trying to tell you to stay undercover.
Okay.
So. All
I'm
right,
going
you.
to All right, well, what do
Roll a
I'm
stealth
gonna
check,
Okay.
maybe? Okay, yeah. That's what he's like, don't stand up,
Yeah.
Okay, so roll your stealth check.
Give me one sec, just check in. Plus 6
Fuck.
right now. Okay. Ah, negative. Okay. cancel. Oh, you deleted my character, that's why.
Yeah.
It caused an error.
Oh, you had
in the middle of rolling it.
Oh, sorry about that.
It's alright. I'm just gonna type it. There.
The fuck? Why is this not...
Oh, it's plus 9, not
6. This is what happens when it crashes. God damn it. Properties. Okay, alright, there we go. Good. Okay, so you got a 9, or you got a 20, you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright, so we're going to enforce you to the next map. After I
added my rank,
paste your stuff. Okay. So, you end up on the branch of this tree. All right.
Okay.
And the creatures in front of you are clearly visible, and they seem to be moving in to attack a blue bird. They seem to be, like, cornering it on this branch. The bird looks injured. It seems as though its wing is pretty badly damaged from scratch wounds possibly caused by these creatures. As for... shit. As for what the creatures look like... wow, that is retarded. It didn't save what I put. Basically, they look like... they look very bizarre, like almost magically inclined, you can think. But they look like feral cats as well, but almost like kittens in a way. They're roughly the size that you are at this point. Maybe a little bigger.
Okay.
And they're cornering this bird that's roughly your size. Okay, so I'm going to roll to see if they notice you guys. Okay. These creatures, they turn around and it seems like they notice you immediately. And seeing that you have weapons on you, they hiss. And we are going to enter initiative order. Okay?
Okay.
So, Caspar's gonna go. He's gonna roll an 8.
I rolled a 12.
Okay. Initiative, add to initiative, 8 and 12. Let's see what they get. They get a lot.
All right. Oh, of course they do.
Nat 20. I kind of figure that's enough to beat you guys.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay, these things... okay, what is their attack? Ooh, they got a big attack. Okay, what is their dex? Dex is that, so I get plus 6. Alright. Okay, these things begin, like, moving at you. And it seems like they're having, like, they need to be careful with their steps, given how slim this branch is. But they do successfully make their way towards you. And they both are going to move towards you. You can't charge on this, it's, like, difficult terrain.
Okay.
So they both move into position, and they are trying to hit what AC for you? You do not have your breastplate on. Actually, I guess I should roll 1d2, and we'll put, actually, 1d4. Casper's lows, your highs. Okay, highs. Okay, yeah, they're both attacking you. All right, so what's your AC?
All right, it is currently...
I think it's just your plus dex right now.
It's currently showing as... 15. What's that from?
Should have your plus dex. You don't have your shield on either.
Yeah.
So maybe your shield was on.
No.
What's your dex?
Oh, I have fighting defensively on. That's what it is. Flanking or something.
Oh. What's your plus to dex? Or wait, fuck.
Three.
Never mind. Okay, I take it back. You're flat-footed because you haven't acted in combat. So they're trying to hit a 10, actually.
Okay,
yeah, they're going to hit. How much damage do these things do? Yeah, I know. That's why I was saying, like...
Yeah.
So it's like they have to hit a 10, essentially. But, however, these things don't hit the hardest, so...
Can I, be fighting defensively?
No. You need to be aware that there's, like, combat happening. To fight defensively, you also have to attack. To do the full round action that's total defense, you need to be aware of the danger at hand. Mm-hmm. Okay, so these things both attack, and they both, like, leap at you and, like, try to bite you. And they each, like, grab an arm and begin to tug. And you can feel the teeth just, like, rend on your plate mail. And some of it actually, like, chinks through. Like, a few pieces of your armor, like, rip off under the pressure of these things. And you begin to bleed underneath. Quite significant cuts, actually. You're going to take 11 points of damage total. So you're in a bad way right now. But you know that you need to finish this fight one way or another.
Okay.
All right, so you are up. Sorry, I thought that was more obvious.
There we go. I was just adjusting my health in this program so I can be active.
Okay.
I'm going to... Do I have anything on me? I have a potion of cure moderate wounds, but...
Can't you really do have a 5-foot step backwards, if you would like to use it.
I'm going to do that.
Okay.
And then I'm going to drink the potion of cure moderate wounds because I'm really low.
Okay. So roll for the healing.
Let me see what it is real quick. 2d...
2d8, right?
8 plus 1 per point of caster level, and it's caster level 7, so... Okay. 2d8 plus 7... Boom. 23.
Boom, 23. That's almost bring you back to full, right?
No.
Like three quarters?
Bring me up to 30 out of 50.
Oh, okay. All right. So you pull it out and quaff it, and that will be your turn. Caspar is up. And he is going to draw his sword and try to attack. And he just, like, the footing on this tree is just so unstable that he's not really able to get a good attack off. Alright, so let's go ahead and roll.
I knew the DNA was going to turn into a roller coaster track.
Okay.
Alright.
This thing steps forward. Okay, the first one bites. Actually, it needs to do more than that, so... Oof. Man, these things have such high attack bonus.
So to be able to, like, total defense, you have to at least have a standard action. Or you have to use a standard action before you get the bonus. So that's how it works, so, like...
Yeah, but it's like
until your turn, and then once it is your turn.
I made it so that you also have to be aware the threat is the thing. Like, if otherwise, right. But what I'm saying is, if you could just use it like without knowing there's a threat, then that would mean that you could like total defense your way through a dungeon. You understand what I mean?
Oh yeah.
So it's like silly.
That's good. But you'd be walking slow and it doesn't give you a...
Right. You'd be moving at your normal speed.
Bonus versus...
Not a double movement.
I think it does.
It would give you the plus 4 AC.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's like...
I see what you're saying.
Alright, so rolling damage on these things against Kaspar.
I get it.
If I want to, Alright, so... Okay, so this thing, like, hops up, and it rips Kaspar with both of its claws and then bites at him. And although it tries to jump on him, like, Kaspar manages to shrug him off just in time. And it looks like he's only taken pretty superficial wounds, so Kaspar still looks in okay shape. Doesn't look like they got really good attacks on him. The next one, which is attacking you... Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Plus. He does the same, and he jumps up, and he, like, rakes you with both of his claws, and, like, grabs onto your breastplate almost to pull you, or grabs onto your clothing, rather, and pulls you in and bites you, and he's gonna do 13 damage total.
It's a good thing I drank that potion, or I'd be...
And... Let me check. All right, so he's going to have to check his rake as well. Okay, wow. That was very fortunate. Okay, he, like, hops up and tries to, like, rip you with his back paws, but both of them just slide off. And you feel pretty lucky that that did not hit. Oh, wait. Maybe that's why. Okay, so he's only supposed to rake if he has you grappled. Okay, so never mind. I didn't know that. Did not know that. Okay, continuing, sorry. I was, like, checking out what this thing did. So, you're up.